Go Kart Brothers.
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 Hey.
I gotta ask.
Yeah.
Is the second to last Go Kart Brothers Slurms?
No.
It sounds exactly like him with his voice mix a little differently. Nope. No, it totally does.
It may be because I got all those from like audio, like text converters, like online.
I know his voice.
So he may have done that. Like maybe that's his side
possible.
Job.
Yeah.
I don't think he's done that.
No, it's him.
I got all these $5 bills in the mail. So
yeah, you got all those residuals coming in.
Yeah.
Nope.
I should sign up for Fiverr just to see if I get any takers.
Yeah.
Just to do your voiceovers?
Yeah.
I would pay for that.
You got some pipes. You could do it.
Yeah.
You could.
I would have...
You got a microphone?
No one wants to hear Ray Romano's brother.
I would have you say very specific, very disturbing things.
And then when you were done, people would say this, Slurms.
You would not be able to podcast with me after that.
They would say this about you.
Dad, you made that grace your bitch.
You made that graze your bit.
Tonight we are, for the people enjoying our audio format, we have a Talladega Nights theme on our video part.
For the pit crew.
The pit crew. And I want to shout out to the pit crew.
Round of the pit crew.
The pit crew's in the chat room right now. We got some J-Dubs, some JBJ Blaze, and some BeamBot. And a bunch of other people, but they're not talking. So start talking in the chat. We talk at Twitch and Beam. So go either one. Go Kart Brothers.
Woo!
We see it all.
Go Kart Brothers, for audio listeners, is available in stereo if you play it on two different outputs.
And
that happens.
One's right and one's left. Are we mono? Is our shit mono? Is that what you're
thinking?
I'm
thinking it
is, isn't it? I don't know, but I used to do it. Brent does it all now, but when I used to do it, I did it. Our intro and outro was in stereo, but then the rest of it was all in mono to save space so that our file size was smaller for people for streaming purposes.
And some people didn't like
it. We didn't use as much data, though. Huh?
Some people did not like stereo podcasts. I knew that was a minor complaint out there.
Especially in cars, right?
Yeah,
it was just kind of threw you off a little bit. Mono, it came through both speakers, it was fine. You know, and the only time I kept it in stereo was for the intro and outro because they had actual music.
Hold on. Brent, did you just dump?
What did he do?
Nothing. Go on.
Did you
do the thing that I did before the podcast?
Yes.
No, he didn't jack off.
Oh.
No, I did that too.
I didn't have
what up, Ghost Flu? Ghost Flu would suck. It's like, you know, how do I deal with this? I got to get the ghost hunters here to give me some, like, medicine. And then they'll think
I'm
doing meth in my bathtub.
I feel like I'm being left out of...
Ghost Flu's in our chat room. I'm sorry. I'm watching chat.
Oh,
saying hi to folks.
To Slain.
And
Slain? Slain's been watching us since Cotcast.
And he also watched you fail a hitman, so, yeah.
Yes, Slain was here first that I saw.
Yeah.
Hi, Slain.
So, sorry to jump around like that. So, yes, I spilled stuff, but I cleaned it up. I'm all good. What did I screw up? We were talking
about apparently something. It's a spill day. That's a theme so far. Steve, we were kind of late getting started because Slurms spilled everywhere. And now Brent spilled everywhere, so it's just Jason and I now.
And I said,
All Talladega Nights, baby.
I think that's my favorite one, the whole one.
Because he says her name all the
Winifred!
You know, that I remember that was one of the first Blu-rays I bought because it came out with like PlayStation 3 when that was the first kind of affordable mass market Blu-ray player. And that was not a good Blu-ray to display.
No.
Are you gonna get it in 4K with HDR 10?
That was back
in
the day.
I don't think so.
But that was back in the day when Blu-ray and HDDVD was like competing, and so Xbox came out with their HDDVD
drive,
which looked better.
Huh? It did.
The picture looked better, initially. Yeah.
I don't know. I think
at least on my TV, it looked better.
I think Blu-ray has more room, right?
Blu-ray has more room. HDDVD was more affordable to produce, so it kind of seemed like it would have a better backing.
I'm surprised because because that was the common consensus at the time, was that HDDVD would win the whole problem because it was cheaper and
PS3 won it, though.
But the name was cooler. It was the name. It was all in the
Blu-ray
name.
Blu-ray is cooler.
But HDDVD, like, people thought that people would have a better understanding of what that is rather than Blu-ray. So,
well, I thought HDDVD was actually larger, too.
Was I can't remember if the storage space was larger or not. I remember there was a big kind of pro to it. But I think what killed it, though, was Xbox had an add-on. Xbox had an add-on for HDDVD, but PS3 came with Blu-ray in the box, like with the console. So they were fighting an uphill battle.
PS3 or PS4?
PS3.
Oh.
It's time for Steve's fact check corner. The Blu-ray disc has a higher maximum disc capacity than HDDVD.
Yeah, I thought it was. I think Blu-ray had better. That's what I thought it was. Blu-ray had better possibilities, but it was expected to lose because people didn't understand what Blu-ray was.
And it was Sony was Blu-ray, and HDDVD was into like Microsoft.
No, it wasn't Microsoft. It wasn't Microsoft. It was something else. And Xbox sold a add-on, which I think it was $99. But I think they were shooting themselves in the foot. Like, everyone who bought a PS3 had a Blu-ray player.
Right. So VHS won over Betamax because of porn. Porn adopted VHS, and so I'm wondering if the same thing happened between Blu-ray and HDDVD.
Yeah. But, you know, Beta was still in production. I just read a story about that. Like, that was used by a lot of news companies and stuff up until, like, late 90s, early 2000s. Like, that was still in production. It just wasn't commercial.
Right. Another side note, according to the Wikipedia page, another reason I think Blu-ray may have taken off because of longevity, the maximum video resolution supposedly was way higher on Blu-ray.
Yeah.
Like,
we're not even halfway to the maximum resolution of a Blu-ray.
That's what I remember. Like, HDD, it was easier for companies to figure out the tech of it, but it didn't have the potential that Blu-ray did.
God, do you remember, like, DVDs when they first came out? Like, I have the Robin Hood Prince of Thieves, so we have to flip the DVD disc to watch.
Some of those early ones, you had to flip them. Yeah.
I still have that one. It's like, flip the disc. Like, are you serious?
Widescreen on this side and standard on this.
Does anyone remember what their first DVD purchase was?
No, I bought a bunch right away.
I think it was A Few Good Men.
Mine was, I bought two. I bought Kingpin and Austin Powers.
Wow. Good choices.
My first VHS, I got two for Christmas morning when I was a very young thing. I got Casper the Friendly Ghost was my favorite cartoon when I was a little girl, and so I got a compilation VHS of Casper the Friendly Ghost and Batman the movie.
Nice.
Yeah, that was my first two VHS tapes. But I don't know my DVDs. I don't know.
I think I think my first DVD was actually Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park. I may be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure that was.
I don't know what words you're saying.
Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park?
Kiss the band?
Yes.
The band?
They did a movie. Kiss Meets. Y'all have heard of it at least.
I've heard of the band.
I've never heard of the movie. Oh my God.
No.
You're full of crap.
And we're in Detroit Rock City. I've never heard of that.
Yeah, we're in Detroit, and you are full of shit, sir.
No, this is a movie. And it was in a theme park, and Evil Doctor makes the bad kiss that basically is coming out killing people, and it's called Kiss Meets the Phantom of the Park.
Kiss is the band that wants to rock and roll a night and party every day, right?
Yes. So when I was I think we've talked about this before, but when I was in elementary school or before, as I've gone to Child's World, like, my stepbrothers listened to Kiss, and so therefore I listened to Kiss. And so I was a Kiss fan, like, way before I should have been a Kiss fan.
Oh, I was like, God, I remember being, my mom was single parenting, and her friends would be like, do Kiss. And I would go, like, suck my tongue out and everything. Because I didn't know what it was, but I knew that's what you did. Like,
that's weird.
They thought it was funny.
So at a very early age, you associated Kiss with sticking your tongue
out. Sticking out your tongue, and that explains my popularity.
So there's the, I don't know if y'all can see that, but there's the.
That's the first DVD you bought?
No, that was such a joke, but.
No, he's just trying to work it in.
This was on TV. Like, really, it was like a TV special.
No. Okay.
Like, so how could you not want to talk about that?
Yeah.
I think he found the VHS laying around the other day. Yeah. And like, I gotta work this
into the podcast.
Y'all've gotta watch this. I gotta find it somewhere.
I'm telling you, I will never watch this. Nope.
Oh, wait, time out.
I'm not watching that shit.
As soon as Jason says there's no way in hell I'm ever watching it, I put it on a list that I make him watch when I'm sick, because then he watches everything.
You'll never be that sick.
Oh, you watched...
Shannon, if you're that sick to where I have to watch that, I'm pulling the plug.
We're pretty old, and you watched Legally Blonde with me, so...
Yeah, that one time.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't even want to watch it.
She was out of spite. She was sick. Yeah.
No, this is my spite list. I make him watch stuff. I don't even care if I watch it, but I make him watch stuff that he says he'll never watch. It's funny.
You drive us wild and we'll drive you crazy. Dan, dan, dan. Right, no Kiss fans here?
All right.
I'm kind of sad right now.
Why?
Because Kiss meets the Phantom of the Park. No one cares. No one wants.
All right, I want to ask a question here, and I assume none of you are doing it, but I want your opinions. Any of you excited for Nintendo Switch next week?
Nope.
Is it next week?
Nope.
It comes out next Friday, a week from today.
I saw a lot of people who were pissed because they ordered it and Amazon said, "Sorry, we ran out." Like,
oh my god, I ordered it forever ago. Are they sending stuff to people saying that?
Yeah, they like ordered it like 5 minutes after it went live, and they were like,
"Oh shit! Okay, hold on, I'm checking. I might be really pissed."
Oh, he might be really pissed.
They might have ordered it from like the wrong people. Oh my god! Stuff, but yeah.
What are you doing to me, Brent? I got a no kid night. What are you doing?
I'm sorry.
God damn it!
Sorry. They switched it up on you.
Now switch. You're skipping day.
And your neighbor runs over and grabs it, and you'll switch it for the night. So, right. But is it really exciting anymore?
No, mine still says it's arriving next Friday.
There you go.
But no, Jason's plan is to, like, give some updates on, like, you know, his experience next week. So
I was more interested in, did you guys hear, I'm really, really intrigued about the Zelda impressions from today. Did you guys hear any of it?
Like, Tell us more.
I'm Zelda!
So...
I heard that it's harder.
Yes, that's hot. What... Like, a lot of people are saying this is almost like Zelda meets Dark Souls.
What?
Yes, I've seen that said multiple times today. And Dan Reichert, who is kind of like, I would assume, like almost one of the official Zelda, like, who's played everything, says he has not died this much since the NES Zelda games.
Oh, wow.
And that makes me all of a sudden, like, I had Zelda ordered just because that's, I mean, what else am I going to play on it? And all of a sudden, I'm like, oh, shit. I am really interested in this system.
So does it come with a game?
Wii U.
Yes, it is.
So
I'm already going to get the Switch. So
yeah, I something that I would like to have. It's one of those things that it was one of the like it, when it was being unveiled on like that Treehouse weekend thing or whatever they had. I was watching the videos. Actually, I was at your place watching the videos.
Yeah, we watched. Yeah. We watched like a huge stream of it.
You guys held hands and snuggled on the couch and watched it together.
You can't be next to Jason and not spoon.
That's right.
He wants to spoon.
But
the videos actually got me way more interested in the system. I love the idea of it, but like the immediate unavailability for me and just financially, like. Maybe it's me just like working in the I can't afford it, so
I don't think you're like wrong about it? Because outside of Zelda, like I have no idea.
Yes, and that's
the only other thing I'm interested in. I think it might be a launch is the what is it, the Tetris that came up. Yeah, that I don't think that's at launch though.
I don't think it is either.
But the what's that Tetris game that was a huge hit in Japan, like the Puyo Tetris or whatever?
Puyo Tetris.
Yeah, I think that like I'm interested in that, but that's like a that's not a proper
PS4.
Right, yeah.
But yeah, it's that's what like my immediate like justification for not getting it was there ain't shit coming out on that thing, and the one thing that I'm really interested in playing, I can play on the Wii U.
No, you're right.
It's Nintendo. Like the reason why like I give the thumbs up immediately, it's Nintendo, we're gonna buy it.
Yeah, but
it's gonna come out and it's gonna be there and he's gonna flip out if we don't have it. So
but to me, if there were things that were only on it right away, I might be more intrigued by it. But yeah. because there's not, there's yeah. nothing really that you have to have it for.
He has
I
to can, have
I
it.
Can, I, well, no, no, no. But I'm saying
for me, the sanity of our marriage, he has.
No, like Steve will get it. Steve will get it at some point.
I would like to think that, yeah, babe, maybe by Christmas. I
can't live in this house and not have it.
And like, love that Conan Exiles is going to be one of the launch games. That's awesome.
See, Brent, I don't think it is, though. I don't think you should cancel that premium.
I don't think that's true, buddy.
I think that's true.
No, that's not true at all. No.
Conan Exiles on the Switch.
No. Full nudity, right?
That was a nice transition, but yeah.
No, but yeah.
He just wants to get to Conan.
No. I was making a bad joke, but
we're talking about Conan.
No. I don't even want to talk about it. I'm done with that game, I think. But
are you serious?
No. We'll get to that later. I'm still on the Switch. I don't want to move the conversation. That was not my plan, even though y'all think
it
was.
I gotta talk about this now.
We'll go to that later. Because the Switch, like, my kids have already talked about wanting it. Like birthdays are coming up.
Let me take a step back. Like, where are they hearing about it from?
I don't know. They.
I'm just kind of interested in, like, how is Nintendo marketing this? Like, where.
Oh,
like,
I don't know. They're internet kids.
Where are the young people
hearing things
these days?
we do not really block our kids from the internet like we probably should on any way.
My son is locked down.
No, I'm not ripping on you. I'm just kind of wondering, like, is Nintendo doing a good job of getting the word out about this thing? Because
I don't know.
They announced it fairly late.
Jacob, are you out there? Jacob, come here if you can hear me.
We'll see. He may come in here.
We have
the meatloaf. We've got
a guest on Go Kart Brothers. Jacob.
Maybe we'll see. Pour me another drink.
Get him in the mic. I got a lot of questions.
Hey, come here. Come here. Close the door. Come here. Hey, we're recording live. Come here. Come here. This is my boy.
You're live, kid.
This is Jacob. Hey, Jacob.
Hi, Jacob.
Hey, Jacob.
Hey, I'm a boy.
Can he hear us, or are you just smothering him?
Oh, He's just smothering him. I've played Overwatch.
I want a question.
Okay, so, you're going to have to go through me. I don't allow him to listen to headphones.
No, I'm legally not allowed to talk to children.
I've had too long, and you should not hear the words I say.
So, okay, what's your question?
Okay, so where did he hear about the Switch
Where did
for the
you
first
hear
time?
About the Switch, Nintendo Switch?
Just different videos on YouTube.
YouTube videos. Okay. So
what,
people,
what game
like, people
are you
like,
most looking forward to?
What game are you looking forward to?
I don't know. A few of the games look fun. The Zelda game looks nice.
Zelda game?
Yeah.
Okay. So Zelda outside, game? Outside of Zelda, what?
Outside of Zelda, anything else?
I haven't seen many of the games. I know they got like a lot of
That's true.
Like sponsors and stuff.
Sponsors.
Okay.
Sponsors.
All right.
I think they're getting
so I mean, he's
just fist up and go, Copeland's rule, and then walk off.
Copeland's rule.
Aw, he's a good boy to do that for you.
He is. Thanks, bud.
How old is he?
15.
God, it sounds like he's like 19.
I've got to teach him how to drive. That's
but I think like there's the problem. Yeah. Like, I'm pumped about Zelda, and Steve is totally right. It's on Wii U, and that's the only game that he can come up with.
Right, but I would think anyone who's younger is going to be excited about the fact that, okay, it's Nintendo. They've always delivered. They've always produced.
But he's younger.
Sam!
But, like,
I'll get younger. I got a 10-year-old in here.
Yeah, Jason. You are completely in when it comes to video game consoles.
Yeah, I know.
I know that. Like, I can't stand in the way of
it. I'm not saying I'm not.
This would be like massive divorce paper signed if I was like, no, but I don't give a shit, so I don't care. Like, I know I can't, like, this is like a thing of excitement that has to happen in our house.
Yeah.
And I was completely like, I remember the Wii, and that just kind of ended things for me.
Oh, I like the Wii. I had a really good time with the Wii. Had a lot of fun. Like, people.
Yeah.
We had like 5 minutes of fun and it sat in our
kitchen. Oh, no. We had like lots of people.
I played a lot of the Wii.
It was,
I played way more of the Wii than I did the Wii U, and I liked the Wii U.
We played it just a little
bit. Wii U is Go Kart Brothers? Or, yeah, not Go Kart Brothers. God damn it. It was the Mario Kart, and that was it.
Mario Maker.
Splatoon, man.
I didn't play Mario Maker.
Splatoon.
And, I didn't do Splatoon.
I love the Wind Waker remake.
That was good. Wind Waker.
Like, yeah, I mean, we use solid system.
I'm not saying it's not. It's just
but
it
then
didn't
they had
to,
the next
like,
thing, the Wii.
But Splatoon was good.
What was the next one?
It's the Wii U and then this.
The Wii, like, doesn't it seem a little soon for a new shit? Like, they basically went, the Wii U, we fucked up. Let's move on.
I mean, that was
exactly
probably
what that was.
It was a big fuck up, but that was actually probably, like, what, 4 years ago?
Yeah.
I mean, that
seems like yesterday. But I mean, they kind of put it out a lot faster than, say, like I don't think we'll get another,
right,
like, Xbox.
And they put it out really fast, and also they didn't, I mean, that's been kind of, like, agreed upon. They didn't market it well. Wii U, everyone thought it was, like, an add-on to the Wii because of the way they named it and the way it looked. And
you know,
people didn't understand what it was, mass market-wise.
There was a worry about the confusion of it, like, before it came out. There was a lot of other bigger podcasts that were talking about people potentially being confused by it, and I literally was in a Target one time right when the Wii U came out, like a week before, and there was a mom in there, like, questioning, like, if it was something to add on to the Wii, and it was like, wow, holy shit, it is a problem.
Yeah, it's kind of expensive to be add-on
or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, talking to your kid, that's kind of like, that's what I'm worried about, because he knows about Zelda, and I guess we should have, like, maybe questioned, like, well, why else?
Right?
But it's just, it's Nintendo.
Ask him that, but I mean, why are you worried about it? It's a Nintendo.
Well, but he doesn't, like,
the company that they're going to provide games.
Well, no, it's on them.
Like, they've already got a system coming out that you can't buy anywhere right now.
Like, my thing is, okay, so my kids, like, they get, like, one or two games a cycle for, like, these consoles.
Oh.
And so, like, because we can't afford to, like, buy a new game every week. And it's not really like the old days. Like, when I was a kid, the consoles, like, every weekend we would go rent 3 games.
Yeah,
and so you had games constantly. And we should probably do that. Hit the red box, you know, on the weekend or something. But we don't. And so, really, we end up basically buying 3 games that basically cost us $100 a piece. And it just seems kind of odd, right?
No, it's weird.
Like, and that's on us. Like, we need to buy more games, probably.
I'm way hands off when it comes to consoles because I only play PC. So when Jason buys a console, that is between him and Matt and their finances. And so I'm really hands off when it comes to that sort of stuff.
Like, because you don't play any of those. Like,
I don't, but I feel like I'm out of the discussion because I don't care. Like, I don't care if you buy it or you don't buy it at all.
But I would love to play Zelda on a PC. Like, I wish they would just, like, quit making the consoles.
Yeah.
No.
Well, offer a PC version. Or,
I'll be really bummed when if Nintendo ever does that, which they probably will at some point. I'll be very bummed because, I don't know.
Oh, that's dumb.
I mean, yeah,
you're
that
dumb.
Might just be a changing
dumb.
The time, but I feel like some of the magic.
You're an old
lost
dumb man.
Well,
no,
I think at some point all consoles will be like no reason. Like your hardware and your TV will be enough to basically it won't make sense to have a console. They'll just be like, here's the games, play it on your TV.
We're all
but then
we're
I like how Nintendo is trying all this weird shit.
They're starting to do some stuff on mobile devices though, and I'm really still hopeful, even though you all laughed at me so hard. Still hopeful for Animal Crossing on mobile devices.
I don't think we laughed at you.
I would love that.
Oh, got ripped apart.
I don't remember that.
Oh, this was before you. Sorry. Oh.
The Fire Emblem's mobile is not bad. It's decent.
I haven't played that.
It's. I don't know either. It feels almost like a full-fledged Fire Emblem.
Is that like Firewatch 2?
Yeah,
not today.
Based on the Mario Run thing, and so I would say Nintendo's kind of floundered in the market so far, but I have hopes that they'll get
Pokemon
there.
The Pokemon thing saved them.
They'll get there.
They just need to go back to making cartoons. Like, fuck these games.
Like the Mario Brothers show?
Yeah. And Monday through Thursday, Mario, and then Friday was Zelda.
Yep. Then the Phantoms of the Park, Kiss.
That's on Netflix now.
So who all went and watched any of the movies like Hawk the Slayer?
I didn't.
We went on an attempt to watch a lot of movies, and you know what's annoying is a lot of old movies are not available for streaming. We tried to watch none of the Mad Max movies are available to stream at all. Like
except
you can't
the new one.
Except the new one, you can't buy any of the old ones or stream any of the old ones or rent any of the old ones. You have to, like, go buy or rent a hard copy, like, in person.
Like a savage!
Like a weirdo. And what else did we try to get? We tried, Beastmaster you can't get. We went, like, after that episode, we went and, like, tried to find, like, all these movies, and we could not find any of them. We ended up watching the closest thing we could find that was, like, even in the realm was Demolition Man.
Which is amazing.
Did y'all eat some Taco Bell at the same time?
We watched it twice over the weekend.
That's a pretty good one. What about the three seashells?
He doesn't know how to use the seashells.
I don't know how to use
that movie. Is surprising. It holds up really well.
It does really. Yeah. Yeah. It's pretty good.
That's up there. That's not quite A Few Good Men, but close.
No, it's right there though.
It's close.
Right.
It's close.
Yeah. Right, but, next to one of the best movies of all time.
What are some? But we did watch Fury Road, and we are considering this weekend letting our son, who is 12, watch Fury Road. What do you think of that? Because it is rated R. Parent discussion.
What level is he?
What level is he?
What age?
He dinged 12 a couple months ago.
Yeah. There's no nudity.
There's no nudity.
I'm not in the movie.
Not a violence.
There's no nudity, but that one chick has some serious rock hard nips.
Well, and there's
you
a breast.
Friends.
There's a breast milking scene.
But
at one point. But I mean, like, it's not sexual. It's very
not sexualized, and I think I could explain that to him in a post-apocalyptic world. I think this is because the problem is, like, I can't show him any Mad Maxes because none of them are available, and I really would like him to see, like, this is a whole new genre in his entire world. Like, that's kind of amazing.
But it's like the four movies are the genre.
I think just post-apocalyptic, which I typically don't like.
Show him this and then show him The Road. So.
Oh, God, I know. I don't want to watch that movie. You don't want to watch the Shannon.
What's The Road?
What I've heard of, it's a very dark and depressing post-apocalyptic movie.
Well, post-apocalyptic is kind of
I don't want to watch it.
Man,
you know, I actually watching Fury Road the second time, I liked it a lot.
It's
the first time I thought it was okay. It might have been because I watched it on my Atari Lynx the first time.
And, no, you watched it on a lot of beer the first time.
That's true.
Yeah, I did too. And it was good, but like watching it again, we talked about it a lot more, and like it's amazing. It's an entire like
chase scene.
The whole movie's a chase scene, and they cover like what's going on in this little community that they discover, this whole little society, like post-apocalyptic society, within a chase scene, and then
they build
absolve
a lot of
the
world.
Problem, you know, like or confront the problem at least.
And it's a fucking gorgeous movie.
It is. Yeah. So we were watching it on. So we were watching it in the 4K Blu-ray, and it looked really good with HDR. One thing I was thinking while watching it, because Tom Hardy, his role is very minimalistic in that movie.
Yeah,
he grunts three times,
which
it
he
is...
grunts a lot in any movie.
It is expertly done.
Right? Are any of you guys watching Taboo on FX with him?
You know what? I have it recorded, but I have not started watching it.
It's really good, and he is similar where he says some words, but a lot of his exchanges are. And he is fucking terrifying when he does it. And like, I don't know if he can do anything like any type of empathetic character, but he fucking crushes it as.
What are you talking about? He was beautiful and charming in that dream movie that you
Inception,
loved.
Right?
Yeah,
I loved him in Inception, but he was like in the movie for like 15 minutes.
That is great.
And I remember thinking when I first, because I love that movie, when I first saw him, I'm like, there, like he brings a lot to this role that
I fell
have
in love with
lot.
That man. Yes.
Yeah. But Taboo's really good. It's very weird and dark, but it's really good.
I haven't gotten into that yet. I know you watch it, but I haven't even started on that yet.
Yeah.
I keep wondering if I should do that. The guy on the like front cover kind of reminds me of the dude from Vikings. So,
Taboo?
I haven't started on Vikings
just
at all.
The front picture. Vikings is awesome. You gotta watch it.
I know. I gotta watch it.
That's one I've thought about watching.
I just started Travelers though. Has anybody?
Yes, I watched
that. How do you like that?
I like the episode so far.
It's a cool premise.
Yeah,
that's the one with the space-time continuum, right? That's what I'm on the same age.
Yeah. So for people who don't know, that's a show where in the future the world is fucked, so they figured out how to travel back in time to fix things, but they go into, they find when people are about to die and they try to throw their consciousness into their body, right before they die.
Yeah. And hope they survive with their new consciousness.
So the show is a lot of like...
There's limits to the time travel.
Yeah, and then you might meet a person and they might be helping and that person might die, but then a new person comes into their body at some point. It's really an interesting show. It's a Netflix show.
The dude from Will and Grace is kind of the star of the show.
Yeah, he's good in it.
How far along are you?
Five episodes? Four or five episodes?
It's probably
like 9 or 10 episodes, so you're not that far off.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's some stuff to struggle with emotionally later on.
Yeah.
Oh well, I'll get over it.
No.
I don't really do emotional stuff that well.
That's cool.
But I did want to mention before we moved on that we don't have to move on, but post-apocalyptic stuff, 20 years after. Have y'all ever heard of this movie?
Mm-mm. No.
Don't watch it. It's a pretty shitty movie. But it was filmed.
Why'd you bring it up?
I bring it up because it was filmed here in Huntsville.
I'd write it down.
And it was the first gig that we ever did as the Dead Workers. We did the behind the scenes. We filmed all the behind the scenes footage for the movie. One of the actors in it, Reg E. Cathy, is amazing. He was amazing then, and anything I've ever seen him in, he has done a great job. If you watched House of Cards, he is the dude who runs the barbecue.
I love him.
So
yeah,
Reggie Cathy got to meet him, and we interviewed him, and it was awesome. And anyway, it was a post-apocalyptic movie, and you know, for the budget, it just was what it was, and it was still kind of shitty, but it was interesting.
I wrote it down. Other TV news, or we're done with the 20 years, I guess.
Yeah, we're done with 20 years.
Okay.
Wait, one last thing with 20 years. We're not done yet.
Yeah, yeah.
They actually changed the name. The original movie was, what was it, The Mole People, and then it changed to something else and was released as that. But then they sold it to a company who changed it to 20 years after.
Weird.
No, I find it interesting when, like, movies and stories change names for cultural purposes or marketing purposes or whatever. Like, because usually marketing purposes are cultural purposes, so... You know,
true. Yeah.
Like, what is the Jason? Put your headset on. Thank you. What's the Live Die Repeat? But that's not the name of the movie.
Edge of Tomorrow.
Edge of Tomorrow.
Edge of Tomorrow. I think Live Die Repeat's a better title, but they didn't call it that. They called it.
They should have gone with the original comic name, which is All You Need Is Kill, which is
So for people who don't know, we're talking about the movie with Tom Cruise, where he is, it's like way in the future, and he starts repeating this Groundhog Day, where he has to live this perfect day based on alien stuff to save the world. And it is called, what's the actual real title?
Edge
of Tomorrow. And it's a great movie, but Edge of Tomorrow, in my opinion, is a, like, I can never remember the name. I guess it was
supposed to be originally called either All You Need Is Kill or Live, Die, Repeat, but they changed the name because they didn't want it to be a spoiler.
You know, like, the funny thing is,
but in the trailers, they showed it.
Live, Die, Repeat's the thing I remember.
Yeah, no, it's, once you know the movie, it's a much better name.
Edge of Tomorrow is, I didn't really hit with me. But anyway.
You think about it, but yeah.
So, I think Brent's not here, but...
Yeah, fuck him.
But
talk about how good Firewatch is. While he's
actually
gone.
I was gonna since we're still on TV stuff, I was gonna talk about Riverdale a little bit.
Yeah,
Jason and I caught up on Riverdale. For those that don't know, it is the Archie Comics TV show that is on what?
It's on the CW. C-dub.
Not in the big C-dub is what the locals are calling it. Mm-hmm. And so it's actually really good. We've seen about 5 episodes now.
I think the 5th episode was on last night. We didn't see that one.
Yeah.
What show?
But Riverdale.
CW, Riverdale.
The Archie Comics show. Have you seen any of that?
Have not. Y'all liking
it's
it?
Really good.
It's a dark high school murder mystery show.
Yeah, I mean.
So like, what was that one with the bus? that went off the cliff.
Happy Days?
No. It's more recent. Oh, she was in the... Her dad was a detective, and she worked as in the front office.
Oh, you're thinking Veronica Mars.
Veronica Mars, yeah.
I would say it's not as dark as that.
No, Veronica Mars is a little bit lighter than this.
Are you serious?
Yes, yeah. I watched a lot of Veronica Mars.
I've only seen one episode of Veronica
Mars. They're fairly similar.
Watch
Veronica Mars gets raped in the first episode.
But Veronica, I don't know. I guess they're similar.
They're similar
in like high school kids acting like adults, but there's not like a detective working it like
No.
It's more like the OC or 90210, but
no, don't call
it. No, it's not that goofball. It's a little darker, and it's a little bit more of like high school kids dealing with things the way they would, like kind of like okay, this is a big deal, but I don't want to deal with it. You know, like type of deal.
Secret Lies or what was that one?
I don't know. I don't watch all that, but I mean, yeah. Mm. It's not bad. It's not bad.
I actually
like it a fair bit. I wouldn't say it's not bad.
You've got a bag with the logo on it now, don't you?
Yep.
No, I would say it's better than a lot of the DC
Go Riverdale
TV shows Riverdale. That are
What's
out
it on?
There.
What's it on?
CW.
It's on CW.
CW. Okay, so we can find
yeah.
it.
Yeah. But yeah. And so beyond that, I'm looking forward to watching more of that.
Yeah.
But Doctor Strange came out this week, right?
On digital, yeah.
Digital. Anyone watch it?
Or last week.
I have not watched it yet.
Was it last week? It's been 2 weeks?
Yeah, I think so.
You guys have had 2 weeks and watched Doctor Strange?
I haven't. Is it that good?
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
It's really good.
It's really good.
It is really good. Give it a go, man.
It's definitely one that I want to show the kids.
Yeah,
Matt really dug it.
Yeah, he likes that. And it's just, it was like one of those things where like, actually I came home and I just wanted to play video games, but Jason had it on, like he started while we were eating dinner and
that bastard.
Like, I'm not leaving. The credits are rolling. Because you just really enjoy the story. But anyway, and we can't talk about it because you haven't seen it, so we'll move on.
Well, I just added them both to track, so I'll watch them this week. Go. I'll start Riverdale.
To wrap up our TV viewing segment of the show, Jason, you had said you were watching something. What?
Wrap it up.
Jason, you said you were watching something that Brent was watching.
I'm not sure, Brent. Did you watch Sneaky Pete?
Yes. Awesome. Love that show.
I think 7-8 episodes in, so I think I'm at the end, and it's really, really good. I didn't start the first episode. Like, I kind of watched the first episode and dicked around with it until, I think, day before yesterday, and then I really started watching it, and any spare time, I'm watching it right now. It's really good.
It's some of those shows where it's like your hero kind of falls into that trouble. Sometimes they go over the ledge where it just irritates me, and this doesn't ever. Like, I love how they go through it, and anytime he gets into trouble because of how he acts or whatever, it doesn't feel fake and forced, and it just feels real and good, and you don't feel like you want to punch the guy in the face.
I was worried because I have a hard time with shows where someone is conning everybody because they're always so uncomfortable. But this does a nice job of balancing all of that.
Yeah.
And what kind of jumped out at me at the show is because it's kind of created by Bryan Cranston. And I've heard him talk about he's had this idea since he was a kid. And he is the bad guy in the show. And I thought he'd have like a cameo or two, but he's a pretty big presence in the show. And his role as this kind of sociopathic mobster really made me wish those rumors of him being Lex Luthor were true, because he totally would have nailed that role. Like, he is like super nice, and when he needs to be menacing, there is one scene in like the third or fourth episode where he does like a 15-minute monologue that was terrifying. It was really, really good.
Speaking of Lex Luthor, did I mention that I finally watched Batman versus Superman?
No, I saw a tweet, I think.
I think I did tweet about it, but yeah, I finally watched it last weekend.
Did you hate it like everybody? It's the worst movie ever made.
No, It's okay.
It's fine. It's fine.
It's fine. But
I think it's
no underrated. 3 o'clock high.
Oh, come on. We can't stream that either. We looked that up.
But did not like Lex Luthor.
He is awful. He's the worst part of the movie.
Fucking terrible.
I really like Henry Cavill. I thought Ben Affleck was decent as Batman, and yeah. Lex Luthor is such a cool character that can be portrayed with layers, and he did none of that.
Nope,
I
just psycho dude.
Worst part of the movie, and I really hope they change that, because
as much as it was spoiled as to what the big boss fight was going to be at the end of the movie,
yeah.
I still think that it was actually handled pretty well.
It was okay. Yeah.
But yeah, the whole like Lex being every time
he was acting like the Joker or something.
Yes,
like
exactly. Every time he was on screen, I was just like, ugh.
There was no pathos to him. There was no getting like why he wants to save humanity from an alien threat. Like,
didn't work.
That was the biggest bummer of that movie. I liked a lot of that movie a lot more than other people. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times I'll throw it on just to have it on in the background because it looks good and there are fun parts of that movie. But yeah, he is by far the worst part of that movie.
Oddly enough for me, and so very light spoiler, the part, and it was kind of in the trailers, but the part where Batman's having that dream of like the future and it's like post-apocalyptic and you see like all the aliens and shit swarming around him, it's like that stuff was fucking awesome.
That was, and my favorite I think maybe Batman fight scene is that whole the warehouse raid at the end. The way he moved around was great.
Oh yeah. Uh-huh.
How brutal it was, like that was really fucking good.
Yeah, he's fucking rad.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought the only part of Ben Affleck as Batman that I did not like, oddly enough, was the whole turning point when he was just about to kill Superman and then he goes nuts about his mom. I thought that was kind of weird.
I didn't have a huge issue with that because that's very basic and it
worked. It worked in the story, but his acting reaction.
Like, yeah, I could see picking that apart, but I was like, okay, that's totally fine because that humanizes him to him, and that's all you really need. But yeah, it could have been done way better.
They made him go like way psychotic sounding in that part, and I thought it was a little too much.
It was, yeah.
But anyways,
but it is not the worst movie of all time.
No, I'll watch it again.
It was fine. Yeah, it was. I've watched it, I think, maybe 3 or 4 times, and it's decent. It's fun.
Sure.
Yeah.
Doctor Strange is better. But anyways.
Oh, totally. Totally.
Suicide Squad is better.
Firewatch was better.
I don't think Suicide Squad. I think Suicide Squad was great to look at, but if you look at the actual story in Batman v Superman was better. That's not saying a lot. Why were they together? What was the bad guy?
I think they were both just as big of a mess, but Suicide Squad was more fun to watch.
It was a more fun tone. I'll give you that.
All right.
Yeah. I don't think Suicide Squad.
We're comparing crap to crap at this point.
Yeah, yeah. Like a 10-year-old might say. A 10-year-old might say.
I'm 10 years old, but I'll beat your ass.
Come at you like a spider monkey.
I'm all hopped up on Mtn Dew.
You're gonna break us like wild horses.
Like a spider monkey. Go on.
I'll hold your hand up.
I'm Ricky Bobby. If you don't chew Big Red, then
fuck you.
Anyways, you guys still playing Conan?
I love that game.
I love it, and I want to play it. My problem is I'm doing the whole like in school thing at the same time, so it's like hard to get in game. Like right now, my big thing is like I have time for mobile games because they're with me, but. Yeah. And Conan, it's great because it's everything I want to play because I really enjoy survival-based games and it is doing a really good job at that. And we have a really nice, like, cool thing where we're building up bases along the way to get to resources and stuff with our little group that we have on our server. But I'm just not able to devote the time I need to do that, to be a part of it. So how's it going? I feel like I haven't been on in, like, 6 days, so it's hard.
And I think I'm the same too. Like I spent a lot of time like building the path up to the iron.
Yeah.
And I built like a big stairwell thing to bypass the spiders.
I saw that.
And that's kind of like where I left it. And it's just like, it's one of those games where it's just like, I don't know. Like, I wish we had more people playing at the same time to, like, do stuff.
Yeah.
Like, it feels like I'm just going to build all this crap and...
No one's going to use it.
Oh, yeah. And it's basically like, well, I'm just building these things to build it.
So,
and then we'll have to start a new server.
Anyone who enjoys the podcast and wants a game with us, and maybe you have a, like, a desire to play some survival games, Conan Exiles. If you own it, don't buy it to play with us. Like, I will stress that point to no end. But if you kind of are buying it anyway, come play with us. But I always discourage people from buying games just to play with us, because we are fickle. We play, obviously, we podcast about games. We play a lot of different games. We might not be here next week.
Did you guys ever run into it with games like this where it's where you, a game that is survival based, where if you don't play for a little bit and you're playing with the community, you're like, well, I'm not even going to log in because I'm so far behind.
Part of it's either I'm so far behind or it's so advanced that it's not fun. Like,
that's what I mean. Yeah.
And the difference,
like there's nothing to challenge me if everything's already built. And then I think we're at this nice point now where we need people to help. We actually do need survival stuff to happen. But we're not totally starting from scratch. So it's like this middle ground. But I do know what you mean. Like sometimes with Minecraft on survival servers, I'll join in as like, you have everything. I can go everywhere.
What am I doing?
Yeah.
And you're handing me all the stuff. Like this isn't survival and it's not fun.
Yeah, it's like I wanted to play the game, not have you just give me everything I walk in.
Yeah.
So there's a
I built your house for you. Like, well, what the fuck? Like I kinda wanted to build my own damn house.
That's the challenge is like survival games is the fear of death. Like what I would like to do, my goal, if we could build up a little community that like to play Conan Exiles, is I used to play it on a Minecraft server called Craft Theory, and what they did was they reset one of their servers. They have, like, a couple different, like, things. But they reset the server, and they put everyone on teams, three teams. Jason, I know you like three-sided PvP. So everyone's assigned to three different teams, and they use their Discord where everyone's assigned, so like you had your team chat and your team voice chat and everything, and so it was really cool because then they would assign challenges, and the teams that did certain challenges won like that thing. I don't know, but like they had different rewards and stuff too. Like I don't know how we would do it, but the other thing too, I was thinking of Conan Exiles, so you could focus it more on PvP
implementation. We have rewards.
So we have lots and lots of stuff to give out. What are you giving out, buddy?
Nothing. I'm just saying we got it. If we need it, we got rewards.
But my idea would be like to kind of build a small community where we could do like team-based things, and maybe the teams are pitted against each other for certain reasons. That would be fun.
Yeah, and we have full control over the server thanks to a Creeper Host. Is that the right name? Too much.
Yeah.
Thanks for the server. I gotta say that it's absolutely free for us, so that's awesome. But we can basically save the map off that we have now, start a new map, and say, okay, you know, we could even go in and build. Like I was talking to Eric and Wes from the Shaft about doing a Galel. I don't know if you've ever seen Galel, but if you haven't seen Galel, you need to go watch Galel. It's funny. We were gonna do one in Conan Exiles, and it's this like stupid storyline. But anyway. We could build a castle and basically be like, y'all have a week to basically come and kill the castle, and the people who do it get a prize.
That'd be fun. To like have little challenges and stuff. Yeah.
And then when we're done, we put the old map back on. You know. Yeah. So we got control. Be cool. Fun.
That'd be fun. I like that idea. We've got like a small group in there. We need to flesh it out a little bit, and then we could do stuff like that, I think.
Yeah. Well, and there's, you know, we have friends who are playing on other servers and stuff. Like
I played on other servers with other friends because, you know, I like that.
So it's like doing events like that. It's like, hey, we're going to do this for this week.
Just invite them over. Yeah.
You know, so come on over. Everybody jump on. It'll be like active for this week. And then y'all go back to wherever after this if you want. And we'll think of a new fun thing to do.
Cool. Yeah. All right. I think we should talk about that more in the after party for details and dates and stuff. And
sexy details.
No, that's a great idea. I love that. That's cool.
Sassa deets. All got the deets on the sass ass.
Bam.
Got on the end stuff.
Laugh it up, fuzzball.
What? Don't talk to me like that.
Why, you stuck up, half-witted, scruffy-looking nerf herder.
You gotta throw in some Star Wars every once in a while.
Well, sure.
Is that what that's from?
I hear. So, cons.
Yeah?
Y'all are going to Motor City Comic Con? Is that a thing?
Oh, wait,
is that
wait.
True?
Are you saying we're going?
Yeah.
Like you're not going?
I don't know.
I know it's far. When is it again?
Dude,
I do
it's
not
like a
12-hour
drive.
I know, I got hemorrhoids.
Hemorrhoids
brutal,
that long hurt.
That's a brutal drive. I understand completely.
Have you recovered from the last drive yet?
No, I still got hemorrhoids.
At least I don't get ass cancer.
I don't think. Maybe. I'm hoping it's hemorrhoids over ass cancer.
You will be missed. Can you just appreciate the fact that you're beloved and wanted?
I want to go. Like, I'm trying to, like, talk my family into making it, like, a family trip. Like, all of us go.
Because we need someone to round up the pit crew.
Round up.
Slam them!
Round up the pit crew!
Round up the pit crew.
Gotta do this.
And then I'll call my son Cheese.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. The nickname.
Cheese!
You can't give it to someone else.
Here, I didn't want this.
You know what's funny is I'm not taking my son this year.
Oh, that's not funny. I'm not laughing.
Yeah. No. I'm going to actually take off the Friday before and take him and one of his friends of his choice that the parents are in agreement with. They can miss a day of school. And take him on the Friday and spend the day so that he can still have his whole Comic-Con experience. And then, because the hard part for us is, like, we're trying to, like, do coverage and see everything. But then I also have the thing where my son's with me, which is nice, but it's a lot because then I have to drive him back to somewhere that can, like, you know, be responsible for him and then come back in time for the after parties and stuff. I miss about 2.5 hours of stuff because the drive is not
short.
Convenient.
Right. Yeah. In a couple of years, he'll be driving our drunk asses around. So
yeah, it's easy to fall asleep on the ride home.
Yeah.
No, we did. We did Uber last year. That worked out really well.
Yeah.
Around
the place. Yeah.
Yeah. That was.
Oh yeah,
fine.
We got the truck. The truck drove us. That's good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That was good. I liked it. That was my Uber experience.
Uber's the thing.
Fun. But I'm thinking, like, you know.
So what month is it in?
Huh? It's in May.
And that's the other thing. It's I think right around my daughter's birthday.
That's not good.
Oh, she'd love it. She'd love that.
She's not gonna want to come to Michigan for that. No.
No one wants to come to Michigan or anything.
Brent, I love you. I want you there, but you have a free pass because you are far. I get it.
But I want to show up.
Huh?
See, fuck you. You have to come.
There's always a possibility that it might be a chemo week.
I know.
So
I can't control when they have
a chemo. You're still doing that?
Wait, you got to do chemo on the weekends?
Can't you tell them to reschedule it?
I don't know. By that time, I'm not going to be sure because of the way things get moved around constantly.
I don't know how chemo works.
Sounds like a big hindrance.
I know the con is set.
I would just blow that off, Steve.
Yeah, fuck that. What's 1 week of missing chemo?
Also, that is also, and it always happens, and we usually work this out, but it's also the same week as my kids play at their school.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah.
Just pull the cancer card. Say, I got chemo this week. Fuck you, kids.
I think you did that last year.
No, I
wasn't. No, it wasn't yet.
No, last year it worked out because I was still at the other place and I had a vacation that I could use. And I actually went to another one of the showings. But this time.
And we were just like, Steve, why are you losing so much fucking weight? You're fucking crazy. Quit the diet.
Looking really svelte, man. Good for you.
Yeah.
Do you want to do a quick cancer update?
I've still got it.
Oh, okay. No, but I thought you were getting rid of it.
I'm trying. All right. I just got disconnected yesterday. I'll have another in a couple weeks, possibly have some more. My platelets are low, so yay. So I have two more rounds, and then I'll get another PET scan to see where I'm at.
How's your weight? You seem like you've lost more weight.
Yeah, you do.
And no, hair. Like, the hair just keeps going.
Is it?
Yeah, okay. It's because I shaved. I'm actually staying pretty solid around.
Okay, good, good.
All right.
So, I haven't really lost any, but I haven't gained too much either.
So, are you doing, like power 90 two at the same time, just to like
just getting ripped.
I know, like I kind of want to just send you what
Dave,
I need.
It's time to just get really
I
jacked.
Can't lose weight.
You always send me the DDP yoga videos.
I eat constantly, and it's
really.
I like you're really felt, but you like pull up your shirt like the one guy in Step Brothers. The brother, I haven't had a carb in 8 years, and just like 8-pack.
Ripped, yeah.
My chest is almost constantly shaved now.
Good for you.
Yeah.
That's fun.
I got that going for me.
Yeah.
Because
Do you have a special chest blade?
No, huh? But I bet typically you're a hairy man.
Or, I am.
Yeah, that's gross. But
well, it's not terrible, but
gross.
It is.
That's fucking gross. I'm glad you got cancer so you get rid of that hair. It's fucking pissing me off.
Steve and I didn't have a lot of sex before he had cancer, so it's fine. I didn't really see him, shirtless a lot before. It didn't really hinder our friendship at all.
I think it was once, maybe?
I don't know. No, there was never once.
No, without a shirt.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I mean, which is funny because
it wasn't memorable to her.
We've shared hotel rooms and stuff, but I thought
that was the one time.
I don't think I did. I think
that was going to be Steve.
Oh, it's probably true.
Yeah.
And you never cuddled with me. You. I'm kind of pissed now.
God damn it.
Well,
I'm a passionate man. I'm sorry.
And you didn't cuddle with me. I cuddled with your damn cat. It wouldn't leave me the fuck alone.
You know what's
apparently
funny?
I cuddle with people.
He's a cuddler.
Except for me.
We were talking about Motor City Comic Con plans, and our friend Brooke, who stayed in our room last time, she said she's getting her own room because she likes to wake up really early in the morning and we sleep in, and which I don't understand what the big... I sleep through anything. Doesn't matter what time you get
up. We said, like, Steve would be gone before her.
Yeah, Steve's the earliest bird in the room. But anyway, I was excited because I get the bed to myself then, and Jason's like, what? I'm like, well, because...
Yeah, I know. Right, Steve? That's what I said. She was genuinely excited.
She's like, you're going to have to sleep with Steve.
I get the whole girl bed to myself, and you and Jason sleep together.
And I was like, well, no, I'm going to sleep with my wife. And she's like, oh.
No.
That's okay. If I come up there, you can sleep with me, Steve.
All right, good.
I'll come with you. They
Jason
can each have their
Brent,
own fucking bed.
If he's got chemo, can I sleep with you, Brent?
You can get that snuggle factor in.
Yeah, I'll
hell
get
yeah.
you a snuggle. Yeah.
Hell yeah. But I will be wearing my CPAP machine, so you'll have
that's
to
fine.
Deal
I can
with
that.
I'll get like a Darth Vader that's mask just to make
that.
It feel normal.
If I had my CPAP machine, we'd be a fucking mess.
Do you have a chemo CPAP machine?
No, if I had my chemo bag and he had a CPAP machine.
Yeah, got it.
It'd be like, you want to trade? You
no.
try it out for the day?
With all that in there, we'd have to corner off the room like where E.T. slept.
Yeah. But add in my snoring?
Yeah, the place is going to be quarantined.
Is your snoring bad?
While we're sleeping.
I used to snore before the CPAP machine. At one con, this dude like went through one night, and the next night he actually bought Breathe Right nose strips and handed them to me.
Aww.
Said, can you wear these tonight?
Did you use them?
I tried them.
Yeah.
I'm a nice guy. I'm like,
Brent's
yeah.
a sweetheart. I bet he would try that, yeah.
And I said, it really chafed my balls. I don't know. That's just how I do.
I was not expecting that.
I don't think he was either.
But thanks anyways. You want him back?
That's right. They didn't work, man. I still snored all night long. A little higher pitched.
All right. Anything else we want to talk about?
The only thing I got is Clash of Clans, but yeah. I don't know if you guys want to talk about it or not.
Yeah, go for it.
Clash of Clans.
So, Brent.
I don't even want to talk about it. It was the worst week of my life in Clash of Clans. It was so horrible.
Okay, so Brent and I are in the same Clash of Clans clan. Brent's very distraught. Because he built up an army to fight a particular enemy.
Oh, I don't care about that. I don't care.
Oh, you did too. You were pissed. You told me about it. And people attacked that guy. And you're mad.
No. It was this.
But then an hour later, someone else called an enemy, and you attacked the thing they called. So like,
what?
You can't get. Yeah, you did. And you can't get mad at people for not paying attention to the chat when you're not paying attention to the chat.
What are you talking about?
The Clash of Clans.
I have no clue what you're talking about.
I know.
I attacked something someone called.
Yeah.
In today's match.
No, this was like 2 days ago.
Well, I had nothing else to attack. I had no choice.
All right.
No. My thing was, you would tell me, hey, attack these people. And so I'd go build an army geared toward those people. Because you got to go look at their map and go, okay, well, I need to make these plans. And I would spend an hour like obsessing over how am I going to win this fucking thing.
Good.
And then I'd be about ready to attack. And some dude would be like, oh, I just got 3 stars on those fuckers. And I'd be like, well, I can't attack them now, so let's go attack these other people.
And the frustrating part is, too, like say that thing they attacked was level 7, and they're like level 3. And it's like, okay, they shouldn't have done that. But what am I supposed to do? I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that.
Well, it's not your fault.
I know. Like, I'm trying to get the word out there, trying to get people to coordinate, and all I can do is nudge.
Well, all I did was attack what I was told to attack. So if I attack the wrong thing, then it's on you.
Nah, you're fine.
And then today, like, I attacked the other thing, and I'm like, oh, this will be an easy one. So I'll just do it. It was horrible. They had dragons, and they just killed all my shit. And I was like, I need to just quit this game. I need to quit it.
You know what we need to do? You and I need to talk about strategy.
Yeah. I was like, people can watch this. People are going to see this and be like, what the fuck was he thinking?
I don't think
was
anyone in our group does that, because I think if people
hope not,
did that.
It was really bad. Like, no. I was really embarrassed. Like, have y'all ever played a game and then like gone, if people really saw what I just did for the last 10 minutes in this game, they would be like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Like, that's not how you play a game. Like any game. And that's how I felt playing this game, because I was like, I don't think anybody attacks like that. I just did it because I was on the shitter and need to get my attack done. And I spent my gems to get my things done. And then nothing worked. A dragon came out and like freaked me out. I was like, oh my God, a dragon. Like, I can't kill the dragon. What do I do to kill the dragon? And just started plexing men like everywhere as fast as I could. And then it was like, they're all dead. I didn't get a single star. They're going to make fun of me. Like, what am I going to do?
And we're all watching it.
And then I drop out the last piece of shit because I was taking a dump at the time. And then I'm like, well, I just guess I just wipe and go back to my desk.
Yeah.
Rip out those breathe right strips and go back to work.
That's a lot of...
And I just stick and like bring everything together.
I would encourage people to visit our Discord, where we can talk about these things and strategies and post YouTubes of strategies and get more ideas to do things.
Help me, Oprah Winifred!
That's what Brent was sounding like when he was doing his attack.
Over and over again. And she didn't. She said, fuck you, Brent.
She laughed her ass off.
And I cried.
At your tidy whitey wearing ass.
I don't wear tidy whiteys.
But Talladega Nights does.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
That's awkward.
Yeah. It's going to be okay.
Yeah, sorry.
I didn't.
Go ahead and watch the movie again.
In the last war, I didn't do really good. I got like
What's
3 stars
Slayer.
Total. Bad. Really bad.
My name is Crow. And he shoots like 50 arrows. Watch Hawk the Slayer. I'm telling you, it's worth the $10.
You know what you can't stream or watch anywhere? Speaking of stuff like that I'm not watching. Beetlejuice. Where are you gonna get? Yeah, like you can't stream or buy it digitally. Like, I just want to show my kid Beetlejuice. Can't find, like, I have to go buy a freaking physical copy of Beetlejuice.
Like an animal!
Like a freaking archaic caveman to show my kid Beetlejuice. Like, it's ridiculous.
It seems like the more
So, Amazon Prime.
Lately, like, the less movies you can find streaming.
I want old movies available to purchase. And it, like, you already own it, just put it out there. It doesn't cost you anything, just put it out there.
Right. You
let me give you money. Let me give you money, old people.
You can rent it on Amazon Prime for $3.99.
But can I buy it permanently?
Yes, for $12.99.
Mm, I didn't know that. Okay.
Tracked.tv, I love it.
No, because we looked for it like 3 or 4 weeks ago. We could not find it anywhere. I wonder if it's recent. Or maybe we were wrong.
Maybe.
On Amazon Video.
Yeah. All right, take it all back. I'm wrong.
Thanks, Tim Burton.
Yeah, thanks. All right, never mind. My whole complaint there? Gone.
Yeah. Sorry.
There you go.
Yeah, we can watch some Beetlejuice. Fact check,
Brent.
Trying to help out. Good.
Thanks for the fact check. No, but I swear to God, we looked for it everywhere.
Storm stopped me that one.
Jason, back me up a little bit. Didn't we look for it everywhere? And like we could not find it.
Yeah, we did.
It was not long ago.
How many Long Islands?
I might have been four.
It might have been a couple of them.
I don't know. I'm searching on this Amazon.com and I don't see shit.
Yeah. Look on Stampendo.com. And it's
oh, man, you're a free one.
I admit it was like months ago. I lost my house. I never paid my bills.
But it wasn't. Man. I mean, it's been like the last 5 or 6 movies that we've thought of from the 80s or whatever. Like, oh, last... cool. Let's try to find it or even buy it. And it's like, nope.
Cody.
Last week was bad.
That's what Cody's for. Do y'all have fire Amazon stick? Fire stick.
Wait, is this anything
I know.
Legal?
I need to look into
it. It's not.
No, it's not legal.
I don't do.
As soon as they finish the case and it gets marked illegal, then you won't be able to use it.
No, then I'm not cool.
But currently, right now, it is legal because
that seems
they
sketchy,
don't actually download
don't support
anything.
It.
No. Remember Napster before Napster got declared illegal?
Nope. I never used it before.
Oh, it was so awesome before it got declared illegal. That's pretty much what I said. But the thing is, like, okay, so Cody actually has some legit uses. It's just, it's almost like saying, because you can download something on the internet, should you make Chrome illegal or not, right? And that's the same thing with Cody.
You can't just download movies for free. That's wrong.
Using Chrome, you can, if you go to the right places, right?
No, I disagree. Yeah. I think that's clearly a violation.
Well, you're not downloading it. See, that's the thing. You're streaming it from the source that's streaming. You're just not getting the viruses.
No.
It's just not.
I disagree with it. I just want to give someone like $4 and let me watch the goddamn movie.
Yeah, no, I agree. That's why like iTunes went out because they said buy any song for 99 cents and like, okay, that's reasonable. I don't have to buy a fucking $15 album to get the one song I want.
I just want one goddamn song.
And so people did it. And if they did that with movies and you didn't have to pay, you know, $30 for a movie when it came out or what, I don't even know what they are now.
I don't know.
It's
but
like
80s movies. I feel like I should be able to get for like
4K movies are $30. That's weird. It just kind of throws me back to that old time.
But I just feel like old 80s movies, like I should be able to get for like $2-3. Like own them. Bam. Like they should be there available.
No, I agree. Yeah. And I think when you buy a movie, it should be available in any platform that doesn't cost them extra money to do later
on. I'm very bummed that I buy a lot of movies on Amazon Instant Video, and when there are 4K options, they want me to throw out another $25-30 and like that. I get there has to okay, then make it at least like
an upgrade.
Yeah. Don't charge me the whole $30. Like, throw $10 out there, and I'll probably do it if it's a movie I really like.
Like, you bought the script. Okay, now, and the audio. So, now we're doing it in 4K, though, and you only have the 1080p version. So, it's going to cost you $3 to get an upgrade to the 4K. Okay, that's good.
We've run into that problem with copyright at the library. But we might own a certain journal for a certain number of years or like for a periodical we might own it in microform or microfiche, or we might own it in print. Like if the library owns something in a microfilm, we can't just copy, because we have the microfilm. We have a computer there. We could just take the screenshots. We could just digitize that into PDF form. Like, we have the resources to do that, but because we didn't purchase it in that format.
Right. But
we
don't own
it in that format. So I understand.
I'm talking about buying from Amazon, though, and that movie would go directly to the studio.
Then we get their upgrade fee. Because, yeah. I have the wall. I have the wall on a record. I have it on an album.
I
have it on a tape. I have it on a
publisher.
On three different CDs because the CD got fucking stretched. And then I got a gold CD of. I have the wall so many goddamn times that, I could build the wall for Trump. I don't even need. Bricks. Right. I can just use my cases from all the different walls.
But I'm talking about if I bought a
all of us combined, how many times do we own Star Wars?
Yeah, three. But
No.
but I'm talking if I Amazon Instant Video, I was hoping would kind of get all this shit in one place. I've already given my money to Amazon and the studio for the HD movie. So if I gave a little bit more money to Amazon, some of it would also go to the studio. It wasn't like I bought a DVD from a Best Buy or random studio.
Exactly the copyright problems that the library had. We've already paid the publisher
But it should be much more streamlined.
For access to this format or that format or this format. It's the same thing.
Well, then I can go to the library
and
go...
studio's gouging you.
Rent a movie for free, right?
Yeah, whatever you want to call it. They're paying you for the rights for that one access, and they're going to gouge you for every time you access
it. And that's where I kind of feel I think I talked about last week, I feel kind of shitty where... I bought a 4K TV and I have a 4K Blu-ray player and all that. But in 4K TVs have been out for a while, but I still feel like it's not a wide... You can't get content everywhere. It still feels like an enthusiast market, which I guess it still is, but I didn't think it would be that bad.
They could do something like radio, where basically any service that offers movies, you offer the movies, and then you basically detail how many times you played it, and then at that many times you played it, you send us the money for that. Now, how you collect that money to pay us for that is your business, and if you want to do it by direct or by advertising, that's your way to do it. And then everybody gets paid, but everybody can then just watch it how they want to watch it. And it's just per stream, per whatever.
Yeah.
And it's not some crazy, I don't know.
Copyright is regulated per format. And every time format changes, you have to buy a new product.
But I can go to the library and get a DVD for free.
I know it sucks.
That hurts the medium, I think. Looking at 4K videos on Amazon to buy them. No, I'm not going to fucking pay $30 or $25.
Unless it's the Beastmaster.
Jason.
Or Kingsman.
Yeah.
But I bought that physical. But yeah.
Or Eric. Okay, my good friend Eric.
Loves, you're going to buy it again.
He loves Bruce Campbell and probably has every version of Evil Dead ever made. 50 different versions of this same goddamn movie. It's the one movie. It was done one time. They filmed it one time. But he has every single damn version of it and probably has spent thousands of dollars off one movie. And
we have the VHS, our VHSs for Star Wars are in our garage behind the TV, lined up. We celebrate that we own it in multiple, we can't watch them because we don't own a VCR. But
yeah, we still do.
We still keep them and line them up because we remember watching that one, and that means a lot to us. So that's just exploiting fandom in a way.
Yeah. Before we quit the show, I want to say it's Slane's birthday in the chat. So
it is Slane's birthday. Happy birthday, Slane.
Yeah. Now we can get the fuck out of here.
All right, we do have to get the F out of here. Yeah. We're not going anywhere.
I gotta go to bed.
Sing us out, Brent.
Happy birthday to Slane. Happy birthday. About the copyright laws. We hate to complain about breathe right nose trips on my balls, but that's just how we do on the go-kart.
Kart Brothers, we wish happy birthday to you, Slane. Happy birthday.
Yay. Well,
who wants to live forever?
You just gotta keep living, man. L-I-V-I-N.
Hoo-ah!